Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the bullpen. Yep, he's back. We got Shelley Wynter, dear friend of mine, completely a misguided soul when it comes to politics. All right. Very well known conservative talk radio personality. You see it in the background, 95.5 FM WSB host, word on the street. All right. And let's just talk about, dear brother, what's happening in the state of Georgia right now. The runoff between Herschel Walker and Senator Raphael Warnock. I predicted on my radio show that Herschel Walker would either lose or force a runoff. We're in a runoff because of Chase Oliver, the third party libertarian candidate who pulled enough votes in order to stop any candidate from receiving what's called the constitutional mandate to govern. That's 50% plus one vote based on Georgia statute. Okay, I don't want to presume what you know, believe about why this race is in a runoff or the candidacy of Walker and Warnock. Give us your sentiment. I will then opine.
Well, thanks for having me, my brothers. Good to see you. Honestly, it's all about the hatred for the Democrats down in Georgia. Chase Oliver, if anything, stole a runoff, an outright victory from Herschel Walker, because we know libertarians usually draw votes from Republicans. So the 2% that Chase Oliver gained in this election, probably a lot of that would have gone to Herschel Walker, and he would have won outright. But the reason why this is in a runoff, aside from Chase Oliver's being a third party being in the race, I can only attribute it to the hatred for Democrats. This guy, it's amazing to me. I've been following politics since I was a teenager. What's amazing to me is that this guy has sustained $70+ million in personal attack ads since May. That's not including national cable news going after him, calling him names. It doesn't include memes on social media. It doesn't include any of that. This guy has sustained $70+ million in attack ads, personal attack ads, his own son talking out against him, women coming out against him. And he's in a runoff with, by the way, an incumbent senator who outspent the Walker campaign by 130 million, 138 million to 32 million, almost three times the amount, more than three times the amount of money spent by Warnock than Walker. So the only thing you can attribute this to is the fact that Georgia is actually a red state, and that Warnock is what I would call an accidental senator. I love Reverend Warnock. He has been there. He has saved my life. His preaching has saved my life on several occasions. I love the man. But the fact of the matter is that the reason why this is a runoff is because he is actually an accidental senator. 427,000 Republicans who voted in November 2020 race as four Republicans, Kelly Loeffler, Donald Trump, and so forth, did not come back to the polls in January for the runoff. And so that's why he's there. And that's not going to happen again.
Let me ask you this question, because historical context is important. As you have just illuminated, Warnock, he gets in, there's a runoff, he is the incumbent, he's in a runoff, which is rare for a US senator. But Warnock, who had never held political office before, was outspent in the campaign he ran. He ran against an incumbent senator himself that had the support of the machine political structure of the state of Georgia and the support of Donald Trump. He defeated that machine. So let me pose this question to you based on your own logic. When Warnock and Ossoff, the two current US senators out of Georgia, when they defeated the entire machine, was it because of the voters' hatred against the Republican Party?
No, it was because 427,000 Republicans did not show up to the polls because they believed their votes wouldn't count, because they went with a narrative of stop the steal.
Who
did that? We already know that. We know that. What happened.
Let me ask you this question. Who told them not to vote? Right, Trump did. Okay.
Yeah.
Trump told them, don't come back and vote. And I think it was a few things that happened based on the stats. One, you're correct. There was an element of voter suppression connected to the messaging from Trump and allies. As a matter of fact, one Republican stood up at a rally and said, don't you vote on these Chinese machines until they get new machines, which was insane.
Actually, not to cut you off, but that wasn't a Republican. That was Sidney Powell, who was a grifter with the other attorney, whatever his name was. They were grifters. They weren't.
Well, let me provide something in context. It was a conservative rally. Vernon Jones was there, and others were on that stage at the same time.
Who made the comment.
I get that for the record. You all have been saying that about him for a long time, but he was an invited speaker.
Yes.
He was a designed and invited speaker by the conservative movement, the coalition of conservative organizations. So they, I guess, made a mistake. Right? That's what you're saying.
They didn't make a mistake. The party had nothing to do with it. The machine, as you call it. So you can't skip from the machine to conservative groups.
These were not conservative groups.
These were grifters who believed that an election was stolen, who gave
but
a
they
speech.
Are conservative groups. They can be grifters and conservative.
Yeah, that's true. I'm not saying that, but you started with the machine. I'm just basing this on the fact.
I'm talking
that
about
said,
the coalition.
They weren't part of the machine. I would never describe him as part of the
machine. Trump is not part of the machine, technically. He's an outlier that's very effective inside of the machine.
Yeah.
So she had the support of both. That's my point to you. And Warnock defeated both of those machines at one time.
Okay.
Let me go to a dynamic that I think is interesting.
But I need to get your point for saying that. What's your point?
I'm going to my next one now. I have a limited amount of time. I'll say what I said for the record. So in this election, the conclusion of the election, you got a runoff, right? So the numbers are important. We saw a 2-4% decrease in black women participating and black men. Black men are lowered at 4%. Many people thought this was going to be a record turnout in Georgia. Every single platform that I'm on, I said, stop saying that. The reason is because it creates a false sense of security that Democrats have this in the bag. That's what it did, in my opinion, just strategically speaking. And we've been here before in 2016 in Georgia, where you had a lot of early vote numbers. Oh, everybody said record breaking, it's gonna shatter the record. All it did was shatter the early vote record because people who would normally vote on election day decided to vote early. And that's it. At the conclusion of this election, you actually had a decline of overall participation, which I warned could possibly happen if Democrats believed that all those early vote numbers were theirs. But the arrogance of some Democrats who refused to look at the numbers coming out of rural Georgia, I reported on CBS 46, Atlanta News First, the rural counties that had hyper record breaking turnout, and no Democrat in the state knew about it, nor did they speak to it. That's just my point, a little bit of criticism for my side. What are your thoughts on that?
Well, my thoughts are that you were never going to, even record turnout, black men and black women only represent 28% of the total registered voters in the state of Georgia. So even if you had record turnout amongst black women and black men, you still don't win a statewide election in Georgia.
That's not true.
Well, I'm telling you, you still haven't won a statewide election in Georgia.
Okay, but that's not true. I will respond when you finish.
Well, right, but you won. Ossoff and Warnock won simply because 427,000, not 427, 427,000 Republicans, not that they never voted, they voted in November, did not come back out. That's the only reason this state went with those two senators.
All right, so let me
see that now.
Let me provide
you
context.
Never, a Democrat is hard pressed to win a statewide election in Georgia because it's still a red state, despite what the media wants to call us purple or blue. It's a red state.
So let me respond to that with nuance to the data.
There's no nuance to the data. There's numbers.
Sir,
the
Shelley,
numbers bear
Shelley,
me out.
Shelley, if
get,
I
get
was
on math than math.
Shelley,
sorry,
if I was on your show, I would be respectful to the fact that you just submitted something that I'm responding to, and vice versa.
Go with the respect thing. Go ahead, my brother.
Yeah, you know, it's something that we try to do on the left. You all have forgotten about on the right.
Right, but we.
Okay. You're an invited guest in my home, sir. Act like
yes, yes, sir.
Right?
Yes, mustache man.
See? All right.
Sorry.
You went to work with that outfit on that you got right now?
Yeah.
You
I'm
showed
on radio.
Up to work like that.
I wore radio.
You're on TV today.
I wore radio.
But you're on TV
radio.
Today.
Right, but this is my style. God is dope.
Okay.
Shout out to the black.
So here's the nuance. The reason why both Democrats won, and it wasn't an anomaly with one, is because of a few factors. Yes, you had a natural suppression happening. And I've said this many times after the analysis, a natural suppression of conservative votes. Great, that happens sometimes, okay? You also had a hyper turnout of African-American participation. That happened too. I don't think you get a victory without both happening at the same time, because the natural demographics do not favor Democrats in the state of Georgia. So that was my nuance to the data. I think you would actually agree with my conclusion.
Absolutely. I think I just said that.
You said nothing, I didn't use as many big words. No, you said, but I said the exact only reason same thing was because of the Republicans not voting. My point
was, hold on, that wasn't it.
It was also the hyper record-breaking turnout of overall African American participation. Both of those elements combined to create the scenario of Senator Ossoff and Senator Warnock.
And so let me complete your thought. With being only 28% of the total voter base in Georgia, African Americans, male and female, hyper turnout still doesn't negate the fact that Republicans lost almost 430,000 votes. So even if you have record turnout in this runoff, if Republicans return to the polls, you get obliterated. And well, we already saw that. Statewide Democrats got obliterated.
We got 1 minute exactly, and I want to make sure I say this for the record, submitted to you. You can respond to it quickly. The demographics are interesting in the state of Georgia, but people forget that we've had black statewide elected representation. We've had Michael Thurman, Commissioner of Labor. We've had the Attorney General for the state of Georgia, African American male. We've had a Democrat, a female, Kathy Cox, Secretary of State. We've had black, Democratic, black, white, male, female. We've had all of this statewide representation. You're saying that in order to win in the state of Georgia, you're gonna need more than that. Well, remember, there was a time in the state of Georgia in very recent history, the majority, except for one office, was all held by Democrats, and many of them were African American men.
You just answered your own question. Kathy Cox, Michael Thurman all won with the time to the towards the tail end of Democrats winning statewide. So you just answered
my
your own
point,
question.
No, sir.
Michael
my point
Thurman
was
doesn't,
one
Michael
second,
Thurman
one
doesn't
second.
Win in 2023.
One second, Shelley. My point was the natural demographics of the state of Georgia were even less diverse under those black statewide elected officials than they are today. If you're saying this is only about the natural demographics, that means Michael Thurman never gets elected statewide.
That's not true. He was a Democrat in a state that was overwhelmingly Democrat. The state
but
is
you
overwhelmingly
said it was
Republican.
The natural demographics, the race demographics. I just disproved your point.
No, you didn't. The race demographics matter not if everybody in the state of Georgia, white and black, were Democrats.
Everybody was not Democrats in the state of Georgia, sir.
That's
remember,
the shift did not happen. The shift was not complete.
Look at the presidential cycles. Shelley, do your homework. Georgia always went. The state of Georgia always elected or gave all of their electors to the Republican running for president.
That has nothing to do with the state.
That means the majority of the voters in the state voted for the Republican, even when they had black statewide reputation.
Rashad, you are smarter than that. You know the parties are not the same. What I'm trying to tell you is the state didn't go red until Sonny Perdue won the governor's seat. Before that, Michael Thurman and Kathy Cox and
all right, brother,
like
we got literally 3 seconds.
Following
to
the
one.
Whole.
Thank you, man. I appreciate
it. Thank you, brother. Love you.
Next show coming up, I'll bring you back, okay?